I welcome you all to Smarty Education. Today we will be starting with lecture number two of basics of demand and supply and forms of market competition. This is a very important chapter, and if you have not watched lecture number one, please go and watch the lecture. I will give the link in the description as well as in I button. So let's begin with the lecture number two. First of all, let's revise of whatever we studied in lecture number one. So first of all, in lecture number one, we studied about meaning of demand. Demand is an economic principle referring to consumers' desire to purchase goods and services and willingness to pay a specific price for a good or a specific good or services. For example, willingness to purchase chocolate and pay a specific price for chocolate is considered as demand. For example, if I am willing to purchase chocolate and I am willing to pay a specific price for chocolate, this is known as my demand. Okay, in economics. Then we studied about law of demand. Other things being equal means assumptions of law of demand that we discussed in earlier lecture. I hope you have watched that lecture, because I am not gonna make a detailed explanation of lecture number one. I am just making you revise whatever we studied in lecture number one. Okay, quantity demanded will be more at higher price than at lower price. For example, if the Apple product price has increased, quantity demanded will be less, and if the Apple price has decreased, then quantity demanded will be more. Okay, this considered as functional relationship between price and quantity, dx is equal to px. Then we studied about demand curve. If the price is 30, the demand quantity is 400, and if the price is 20, demand is 400, and if the price is 30, demand is 200. This is known as law of demand effect. If the price is lower, quantity demanded will be more, and if the price is higher, then the quantity demanded will be less. Then we studied about assumptions of law of demand. Then we studied about exceptions to law of demand, in which we first of all studied about given goods. What is given goods mean? Inferior goods. With the price fall of these goods, the demand will be less. Therefore, it is known as exceptions of law of demand, because consumers will go for superior product in this line. Article of law of appeal means that those products which show status, for example, Rolls Royce, iPhone, in which you have to sell 2 kidneys for yourself. Then exceptions to the law of demand, in which we studied about speculation, when people speculate about the prices, and there is a possibility that the price of that product will increase in the future, then people will not act according to law of demand. For example, gold. If the price of the gold is going to increase, people will purchase more for that gold. Okay, consumer psychological bias means if the price is lower and the consumer wrongly biased against the quality of the commodity with the price change, he may contract with the demand. Then the next time he will not buy anything when there is a fall in the price. For example, purchasing bad quality laptop in the sale of Amazon. Now let's talk about law of supply. In law of supply, we read about that supply represents how much the market can offer. The quantity supplied refers to amount. The quantity supplied amount of a good producer are willing to supply. That's what we read about in law of supply. Okay, so there is a direct relationship between price and quantity supplied. Please remember this, very important from the perspective point of examination and relevant. Then we studied about difference between supply and stock. What is difference between supply and stock? You have to write down in the comment section, and don't forget to write present in the comment section. And don't forget to write difference between supply and stock. I have very well understand you. I have very well make you understand the concept between supply and stock. Okay, ceteris paribus means if the price will increase, producer will be willing to offer more at a specific price of increase to quantity. Increase in the price, producer will offer more to consumers. Okay, that's it. Ceteris paribus. Assumptions of the law of supply means those things are very necessary. I am not going to explain you in detail, because I have already explained you those things in detail. Okay, then we read about equilibrium price. Equilibrium price means when the quantity demanded and supply is equal. It is known as equilibrium price. For example, if you order someone to make specific jewelry and he supplies you specific jewelry, demand and supply will be equal. This is known as equilibrium price. Then we read about equilibrium price definition, in which supply and demand is intersecting at a point. Okay. Then we read about elasticity of demand. In economics, the elasticity of demand refers to how sensitive the market for a good is to change in other economic variable, is to change in other economic variables such as price and consumer income. Okay. Demand elasticity is calculated by percentage change in the quantity demanded divided by percentage change in another economic variable that we studied further in the lecture of lecture number 1. If you have not watched the lecture number 1, please go and watch lecture number 1. A higher demand elasticity for an economic means the consumer are more responsive. If any other economic variable such as price and the response is greater, it is considered to be elastic. In other words, I have told you in the video, please go and watch lecture number 1. Then we got to know how to derive formula for price elasticity of demand. Price elasticity of demand basically refers to change in the demand due to price change of a commodity. Then we studied how to derive the formula change in quantity upon change, the original quantity upon change in price. Then simple mathematics happened. It was down here, denominator up to numerator and denominator to denominator. Okay. Then we studied about types of price of elasticity of demand. First of all, the demand for a product can be elastic or inelastic. Elastic demand is the one when the response is greater, when the response is greater with the small proportional change in price. For example, Parle-G. I hope you all have eaten Parle-G biscuit once in your life. If the Parle-G increased price to 6, there will be greater response. Even there was an industrial crisis when the Parle-G increased its price. But for current example, it is Apple. Okay. Inelastic demand is one when there is relatively a less change in demand with greater change in price. For example, petrol. Okay. Then, perfectly. Then the last topic that we studied in lecture number 1 was perfectly elastic demand. When a small change in price of a product causes a major change in its demand, it is said to be perfectly inelastic. Okay. A small rise in price can lead to demand to zero. For example, the price increase and the demand led to zero. And if the price decreased, the demand went to infinity. Okay. Now it's time to begin our lecture number 2, perfectly inelastic demand. So till now we have studied perfectly elastic demand. Now there are another types of price elasticity of demand. Now let's begin with perfectly inelastic demand. A perfectly inelastic demand is one when there is no change produced in demand of a product with change in price. For example, if you increase product price from 1, 2, 3. For example, product price increase from 1 rupees to 3 rupees. There will be no effect on its demand. It's elasticity of price equal to zero. Please remember this, very important. For example, petrol is the best example. Even if the petrol price increases, the demand will not fall because it is an essential product. Even another example is water. Now, let's talk about relatively elastic demand. What is relatively elastic demand? In relative elastic demand, what happens that demand, when proportional change produced in demand is greater than proportional change in price of product. For example, I increased my product price from 50 to 60. At the price of 50, 100 quantity was demanded, and at the price of 60, 50 quantity was demanded. Therefore, greater than proportionate change in price of a product, the numerical value of elastic demand changes between 1 to infinity, and it is less than 1. Elasticity of price is less than 1. Okay. Now, let's talk about relatively inelastic demand. What is relatively inelastic demand? Relatively inelastic demand is one when the change produced in demand is less than the percentage change in price of a product. When the change is less as compared to change in price of a product. For example, previously I was selling my product at the price of 10. Quantity demanded was 88. Quantity demanded, then I further increased my price to 40. But there is a very, very, very little impact on my demand. That is 80. Only a little bit of demand has been changed. This is known as relatively inelastic demand. Now, let's talk about unitary. Unitary elastic demand means as soon as
unitary elastic demand,
what happens that if the demand has increased, then the price will simultaneously increase. For example, demand increase from this point to this point, same as the price increased too in the quantity one. Okay, now let's talk about factors affecting price elasticity of demand. This is a very important topic. I want your full concentration on the topic. Okay, so factors for the first factor is price level. What is price level? The demand is generally elastic for moderately priced good, but the demand for very costly and very cheap good is inelastic. What is inelastic? Means whatever goods that will be luxurious, its demand will be inelastic. The rich do not bother to pay the prices of the goods that they buy, very costly goods. Okay. For example, Toyota car increased the price from 5 lakh to 520. It will not make a very impactable thing on the demand. Now let's talk about availability of substitutes. If a good has close substitute, the price elasticity of demand for a commodity will be very elastic. Will be very elastic means if its price in another economic variable such as price and other things changes, then the people will switch to its alternative. For example, wood has so many substitutes, therefore such kind of goods or services where there are no many substitutes, demand is very elastic. For example, its wood substitute is petrol, kerosene, coal. If the wood prices increase, then people will use more petrol, kerosene and coal because their price is less. Now, let's talk about necessity. If a good is necessary, then the demand will be inelastic. I told you that what is inelastic mean? Inelastic means that if the price increases or decreases, but there is not a great response in its demand means there is not likely to be very much happening in its demand. For example, water is necessary. Therefore, even if its price increases, there will be inelastic demand because it is very necessary product. For example, petrol is even necessary for our vehicles. Now let's talk about time period. Over a time of good, a good tends to become more elastic. Therefore, consumers and businesses more finds time to find alternative. For example, if the price of the gasoline goes up, when after the time period people will find substitute for either they may use public transport or switch to electric vehicles. Therefore, what is time period means? People will have sufficient time to find substitute, therefore they will find it because of elasticity of demand. Therefore, after a specific period of time, the product can become elastic. Its demand can become elastic from inelastic. Now let's talk about another factor, that is habits. If the product is habitual for a person, then the demand is likely to be inelastic. Nature of commodities. The demand for necessities is inelastic. For example, if the product is necessary, then its demand will be inelastic. For example, water. And if the demand is luxurious, its demand will be inelastic. And those products which are for comforts and luxury is elastic. I think it is inelastic because its usage can also be postponed, either it is necessary or not, because some people purchase only necessary goods. Various uses means if a commodity has various uses, then the demand will be very, very, very elastic demand, such as milk and wood. Okay, a commodity having only fewer uses will have inelastic demand, for example, mobile phone. Okay, postponing consumption means if a product usage can be postponed, then its demand will be considered elastic. Why elastic? Because the demand for MP3 is elastic because its use can be postponed for some time, but the demand for rice and wheat is inelastic. Now let's talk about income elasticity of demand. What is income elasticity of demand? Income elasticity of demand is the degree of responsiveness of demand to the changing income. Means elasticity of demand is the degree of responsiveness. When there is a change in income of people, the demand will be more or less. It's maybe depend on people's income. Professor Watson has also defined it as income elasticity is the demand is the rate of change of quantity with respect to change in the income. Other determinants remaining constant. Other things being equal, I have already told you what are other things. The income elasticity of demand can be measured by following formula. Percentage change in quantity demanded upon percentage change in income. and their formula is percentage change in quantity demanded is equal to new quantity demanded upon original quantity, and percentage change in income is equal to new income upon original income. Now let's talk about gross elasticity of demand. For example, the responsiveness of demand in price of a commodity is called elasticity of demand in price of related commodity. Gross elasticity of demand is the rate of change in quantity associated with change in price of related goods. Okay, let's take a simple example. Let's take a very simple example for proving it. For example, tea price increased. Okay, then some tea lovers will move to coffee. Okay, some tea lovers will move to coffee. Okay, same happens in if the price of coffee increases, the coffee lovers will move to here. Okay, so percentage increase in quantity of demand A, percentage increase in price of product B, and cross elasticity of demand is denoted by EC, cross elasticity of demand. Okay, main measure, cross elasticity of demand is equal to infinity when commodity X is nearly perfectly substitute for Y. Okay, commodity X and Y are not related. For example, bicycle and petrol. Are X and Y not complementary? Means car and petrol, example for it. Okay, now let's move on. So now let's talk about increase and decrease in demand and expansion to the contraction of demand. When the demand will increase, changes in demand include an increase or decrease in demand due to change in price of related goods, the income of consumer, preferences of consumers, etc. The demand for a product or service changes. So a product demand can be increased or decreased in demand due to change in price of related goods. Now let's talk about increase in demand. When the demand changes not because of price but because changes in other determinants of demand, for example, consumer's income, market situation, it is a case of either increase or decrease in demand. Increase in demand means more demand at same price. Increase in demand are shown by shift to the right in demand curve. Okay. These could be substituted by fall in number of complement or rise in income. For example, consumer income rise. So, for example, they will demand at the price of 60. First of all, they were demanding only 500 quantity. Then at the same price, if their income has increased, then the same quantity will, same price quantity demanded will be more. Now let's talk about decrease in demand. What is decrease in demand? It is a very, very, very important concept. Means less demand at same price. For example, first of all, at the same price the demand quantity was 300, and at the same price now the demanded at 200 quantity at the price of 60. Okay, this is known as decrease in demand. Expansion and contraction of demand means expansion or contraction. When the quantity demanded of a commodity increases result of fall in the price, it is called expansion. For example, there was my constant price P1, but I reduced my price from P1 to P2, then my quantity demanded getting higher from week to week. First, for example, it was quantity 1, then quantity 2 was demanded and quantity 3. Okay. It is called contraction in demand. And demand decreases as a result of an increase in price. For example, my price increased to P3. Then what happened that my quantity demanded was less to quantity 1. Okay, this is a contest price. Now let's talk about forms of market competition. Very, very, very important topic. Either 1 or 2 marks MCQs will definitely be asked from this topic. A variety of market structure will characterize an economy. There will be a variety of market structure will be existing in an economy. Such market structure essentially refers to the degree of competition in world. Okay. So let's discuss 5 basic type of market structures in any economy. The first one is perfect competition. In perfect competition, what happens that there are large number of buyers and sellers. All the sellers of the market are small sellers in the competition with each other. There is no one big seller and all the products are homogeneous. Profit maximization should be motivation. There is free entry and exit from the market. For example, a vegetable market. All the products are homogeneous. Okay, they are homogeneous. Profit maximization is their motivation. Yes. Their entry and exit is easier. Yes, it is easier. So it will be considered as a corporate competition, like a vegetable mandi or sabzi market. Now let's talk about monopolistic demand. There is a more realistic scenario, means this is more common in our real life, that actually occurs in real world. In monopolistic, what happens that there are still large number of buyers as well as sellers, but they do not sell homogeneous product. For example, the products are similar but seller. For example, there are different toothpaste brands available to sell in the market, but slightly there are different of tests. For example, Dantkanti will taste like Ayurvedic, Bico will taste like Ayurvedic, and the Colgate will taste like chemical. This is known as monopolistic demand, in which there are large number of buyer and seller, but the product taste is slightly different from one another, differentiated in terms of taste and flavors. Remember this. In oligopoly, what happens in oligopoly means there are only 3 to 5 dominant ones are considered the norm, because there is a restriction barrier to come in the market. So in the case of oligopoly, the buyers are far greater than the seller. The firm in this case either compete with another or either collaborate with each other. They use their market influences to set the prices. For example, Jio. If Jio reduces price, then Airtel and Voda have to reduce their price. In an oligopoly, there are various barriers to an entry in the market, and new firms find it difficult to establish themselves. For example, telecom sector, because telecom sector requires a very great investment for setting up everything. Therefore, it is the best example of oligopoly. Okay, now let's talk about monopoly. Means there is only one seller, so a single firm will control the entire market. For example, Microsoft Windows. Only Mac and Windows are available, but still Windows covers a large market. Therefore, it has a monopoly in the market compared to other operating systems. Okay, consumers do not have any alternative and must pay the price set by the seller. Okay. Now let's talk about duopoly. Is a kind of oligopoly, means in oligopoly there are only 3 to 5 dominant firms, but in duopoly a market dominated by small number of firms means there will be only 2 firms. Okay, for example, Visa and MasterCard in USA. Now let's talk about elasticity of supply. What is elasticity of supply? The elasticity of supply establishes a quantitative relationship. Remember, very important from the examination point of view, establishes a quantitative relationship between the supply of a commodity and its price. Hence, we can express the numerical change in supply with change in price of a commodity using the concept of elasticity. Okay, so PE stands for price elasticity of supply. The quantity supply doesn't change, it's a price. In English, the elasticity of supply basically refers to that, means that there should be no effect of price changes. For example, now let's talk about the types of elasticity of supply. Then you can get to know what is elasticity of supply and then what is types of elasticity of supply. The first one is perfectly inelastic supply. What is perfectly inelastic supply means a service or commodity has perfectly inelastic supply if a given quantity of it can be supplied whatever may be the price. Okay, whatever may be the price, for example, an exclusive painting of Mona Lisa, whatever the may be the price, people will purchase it. Therefore, price and quantity supplied will be equal. Okay. Now, let's talk about relatively less elastic supply. When the change in supply is relatively less when compared to change in price. Okay. When the change in supply is relatively less when compared to change in price, we said that commodity has relatively less elastic supply. In such case, the price elasticity of supply assumes a value less than 1. In relatively less elastic supply, what happens that when the change in supply is relatively less when compared to change in price. For example, my price increased to 50 and the demand of quantity demanded is only 46. Therefore, the quantity supply is less compared to price. Very little difference between them. Now let's talk about relatively greater elastic supply. What is relatively greater elastic supply? When the change in supply is relatively more when compared to change in price. When the change in supply is relatively more as compared to change in price, we said that commodity has greater elastic supply. In such case, the price elasticity of supply assumes a value greater than 1. assumes a value greater than 1, the quantity supplied changes by larger quantity percentage change in price. So what happens in relatively greater supply, that when the change in supply is relatively more when compared to change in price. For example, what happens that if I increase my product price, but when the supply is relatively more, it will be considered as relatively greater elastic supply. And the relatively greater inelastic supply, okay, now let's move on. Unitary elastic supply. For a commodity with a unit elasticity of supply, the change in quantity supply of a commodity is exactly equal to the change in price. So whatever there will be a change in price, the change in price will be equal to the quantity demanded. For example, price change to 50, demand will be changed to 50. Okay. Now let's talk about perfectly elastic supply. A commodity with a perfectly elastic supply has an infinite elasticity. In such a case, the supply becomes zero with even slight fall in the price. So what happens in perfectly elastic supply, then if the price decreases, then the quantity demanded will be very less. Okay. And if the price increases, quantity go to infinity, as you are seeing in the graph. Now let's talk about factor influencing the elasticity of supply. Last topic, I want your full concentration on this. The first one is price of goods. What is price of goods? The supply and elasticity of goods depend upon the price of good. If the price of good increases or decreases, the quantity supply of will also increase or decrease. Means if the price increases, supply will be less, and if the price decreases, supply will be more. Okay. Price elasticity of supply will depend on the price of goods. Elasticity of supply may be greater than, less than, or equal to 1 depending on the price that is changed. Probability that the price could change in future. If the seller thinks that price will increase, then he will purchase more and the supply will be more. If the price will decrease in future, then there will be a less supply. I hope you got the point. If you didn't get any point, please comment down in the below. I will definitely reply in less than 2 hours. Conditions regarding cost of production. Means if the cost of production of a good increases, the curve shift upward, means it will go as this curve. Then the quantity supply of goods will decrease at any particular price. Now let's talk about last two factors. First one is nature of good. The supply of a good depends upon the nature of good, e.g. on the perishability and lumpiness of the good. The more the perishability or lumpiness of the good, that will be more localized. For example, fruits are very perishable. They can be spoiled within few days. Therefore, it is known as perishable goods. Therefore, it is to be sold in the localized market. Supply of goods at any particular price would be relatively small. Okay. Now, length of time. If the price of goods rises, then by how much supply rise or how large will the price of elasticity of supply? Okay, if the price of good has increased, then by how much would supply rise? This is considered as factor of length of time. Okay, for example, gold price has increased, then the jeweler will try to sell more. Okay, that is why the elasticity of supply in the longer market would be larger than that in the shorter period of market. Longer period means preference. Now, it's time to solve some MCQs. A service or commodity has, if a given quantity can be supplied, whatever may be the price. I have told you in the video that it is perfectly elastic supply. Okay. Now, let's talk about, refers to the market situation in which there is a keen competition, but neither perfect nor pure group of large number of small producers or suppliers having some degree of monopoly because the differentiation of their products. Okay, that is monopolistic competition. I have told you about that with the Colgate example. Okay. Now, let's move on. When demand changes not because of price but because of change in other determinants of demand, it is a case of. Okay. So this question answer is not gonna tell by me to you, because you have to write it in comment section. Write down answer in comment section if you have watched video carefully. Then I think you will be able to predict the answer very well. Okay, now
the quantity demanded of a commodity increases as a result of fall in the price.
It is called when the quantity demanded of a commodity increases as a result of fall in the price, it is called increasing demand. Okay, that's it for today's guys. I hope you liked the lecture. If you have liked the lecture, please like the video. I have worked very hard on the video, and in the description box you can find notes. And if you want to join my private WhatsApp group, you can message me on the number given in the description box or from the link that I've given in the description box. I hope you will support me. Please subscribe the channel, and more content for CSEET is coming on the